U.S. State Department stressed the importance of securing all prisoners in Pakistan, including former PM Imran Khan. Spokesperson Matthew Miller confirmed that Ambassador Donald Bloom met with PTI leaders, including opposition leader Umar Ayub Khan, to discuss bilateral ties and continued U.S. economic support. The Pakistan Army urged jailed former Prime Minister Imran Khan to issue a sincere public apology and abandon politics of anarchy, while rejecting any possibility of a deal with the PTI leader. At a press conference, DGISPR Major General Ahmed Sharif emphasized that the PTI was responsible for the May 9th riots and supported the formation of a judicial commission to investigate the incident. When questioned about potentially lifting the ban on social media platform X, he noted that the decision wouldn't be made in this forum. The Islamabad High Court approved Bushra Bibi's transfer from her Banigala residence to Adiyala Jail, where her husband, former Prime Minister Imran Khan, is incarcerated. This decision followed her petition challenging the sub-jail designation and requesting to complete her sentence at Adiyala. The IMF has urged Pakistan to tax salaried and business individuals uniformly by reducing the taxable income limit for salaried people. This would impose a 35% tax on monthly incomes of ₹333,000. The global lender also recommended retaining the current ₹50,000 income tax exemption threshold and withdrawing tax credits and allowances, including those for teachers. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu rejected Hamas's recent truce proposal, stating it fell short of meeting Israel's key demands and emphasized that military action is still crucial to secure hostages. Israeli forces have taken control of the Rafah border crossing between Egypt and Gaza, which Netanyahu described as a significant move to dismantle Hamas's military capabilities. UN Humanitarian Chief Martin Griffiths warned that Israel's incursion into Rafah will lead to more death and displacement. He noted over 1 million people remain in Rafah, including 600,000 children, and Israel's closure of the Rafah crossing has blocked aid and staff movement. Severe storms battered the Midwest in the U.S. on Tuesday, unleashing heavy rain, strong winds, and tornadoes. Southern Michigan was hit by multiple tornadoes that damaged buildings but caused no casualties. Donald Trump's trial in Florida over classified documents has been indefinitely postponed, reducing the chances he'll face a jury before the November 5th election. Originally set for May 20th, Judge Eileen Cannon cancelled the date but did not provide a new one, with pre-trial hearings scheduled through July 22nd. Chinese President Xi Jinping arrived in Belgrade on Tuesday for a state visit to Serbia, welcomed by the president and other officials. His visit to Serbia is part of a European tour following a stop in France and preceding one in Hungary.